just a little talk about this instrument. This is an instrument generally used in USA, South America. Is an instrument that in Europe they don't use. In Europe, the button accordion is mostly two row, or if they have three row, they have two row more one row of alteration. And the idea of an instrument is totally different from this instrument. Just a little moment of story, you know. They first start with only one row and two buttons, and they make a very simple kind of music. After they make two rows, and they like this, and the instrument was, the first row was G, and the dominant D7, and the second row was C, and his dominant G7. So this is the most used kind of button accordion with two row. Having a third row, if with this system use a fourth upper. So from C we go to F, and we have F and the dominant C7. So this is the idea of this instrument, if to have a fifth, no, you know, so a fourth upper, G to C, a C to F. In the button accordion used in Europe, the most used system, invented and perfectioned by a French, was to have only two rows, and the third row with the alteration, the sharps and the flat, and having here another some alteration in the bass. As a system I don't play, I play only the two or three row in this. This is I think it can be interesting for you, because with this instrument you can play the blues, you can play the pentatonic of some scale of G, of C, so you can play some kind of music that with the two row or three row European music you can do, and instead you can do with them thing you can do with this. So this is they are similar in the form, but different in the idea. After this presentation, I want to talk a little. Book I write from a composition I made. That is like a trip from our country till the new world. So we have not so many time, so I have some only sample. This song is called Racali. Racali is a little place in the Adriatic Sea near Venice, and is like an imaginary start of a trip with the ship, starting from our countries in North Italy. So I play it. Thank you. A song is called Ballo dei Pastizieri, Dance of Bakers, because in 2009 with the group I have toured a lot in Europe and here in USA too. The name of the group is Causi, a group from Southern Italy, Salento. I made the music for an opera, a little opera, who was found in the bibliothèque of Lecce, and they found this opera without the music. The music was lost. So we make the music for this opera. We didn't yet make the opera on theater complete, but we have make some sample in Institute Bibliothèque, and this opera is called La Rassa Butte. So I play for you Il Ballo dei Pastizieri, Dance of the Baker. The name is Acaia. Acaia is a castle near Lecce in the south part of Italy, and is a castle who was attacked by the Moorish, the pirates of the from the Ottoman Empire during the fight between the Venetian Republic and the Moor. And so this is Acaia, is a pizzica. And I propose after this small trip, musical trip, a little workshop about the pizzica and the rhythm of the pizzica. Sorry. Thank you. Thank you.
Could I ask a question? What other types of Italian tunes use that same rhythm? What other types of songs or dances use that same rhythm?
I have an expert. She is a good dancer of Italian kind of dance. Anyway, there is a style in a dance and musical style in South Italia who is called generally Tarantella. Yeah. And around the Tarantella there are similar kind of dance. They are all near one, close one to the other, and there are two mainly rhythm, the triplet tarata 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 tarata, and the duet pum 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 pum. So when you play the bass, is pum. Is not pum pum but pum 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 pum, and the with the right hand you make like triplet ta 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 ta, and so more or less. It's difficult.
Fabio, can I add something?
Yes.
So what he was saying is that the tarantella has many variations. Like every region, almost every city in Italy has a different variation. And the pizzica is the variation of this of the heel of Italy, mm-hmm. but it's still under the umbrella of the tarantella. Uh-huh. So it's like Abruzzo has a different type of tarantella, Naples has a different type of tarantella, Calabria has another tarantella. So they're all variations, and it comes from taranta, which is the spider dance.
Thank
you. Okay, this is a song I play, it's called Salonique. Salonico is a city in the Greece, no? In the former Macedonia, near where the father of Alessandro il Grande, the Alessandro the Great, was born. And I was there for many times, and I love Salonico. Is a city, I have a particular attitude for this city. So I wrote this song, Salonico, and I hope you enjoy. But I'm very emotional to be here and play alone. And I feel your eyes on me. Anyway, I'm playing my music, so I play always, but. Or any times is not is different from the other, you know. So, and this is a beautiful text. But. Thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you. And another song inspired of to this kind of word is this song I wrote. His name is Hagia Sophia. Hagia Sophia is the former big basilic in Constantinople, you know. Now is after the Muslim conquest, it was the greatest mosque of Istanbul, and now is a museum. I was there and I was so impressed from this place that I wrote this song, Hagia Sophia. This song with the other song I have played, we put into a CD we have made with Caussia called Le Grechesche, who is in an imaginary trip from Venice to Constantinople. I change it. I have more than one register, no? I am always using this afternoon the full one. But I will change register maybe after. Now I need the three. This is have three voice, and for this I need all the three. This instrument you can play the blues in G. You know, this is G, closing, and C, opening, and G, closing. So it's not so easy, because when you close and when you open, you have to change. And with this instrument, you need to use a lot the bellow, because if you open, you change the chord. So, and the fifth of the G is D seven. So. Thank you.
Blues Italiano.
Eh? Blues Italiano, yes. I need that to have the swing and with the this bello is not so easy. But yes. And another kind of music you can do is the E minor blues, because you have the fourth, D minor, and the fifth, E7. To finish this little trip, and I want to play like a four row. It's not a real four row, it's a Scottish, its name is Xoti, because this is the way the Brazilian have contracted the word Scottish from the from Europe, you know. And this is quite a dance music, like lambada, you know, they play with the triangle and the zabumba. With the Tarant, I have other song in this small kind of little travel I make musically, and this is a extract from song I've played with different group along my history of musician, because I'm mainly a composer, and I didn't start to play this instrument when I was a child. But I study composition, and along my musical career, I need to find out some instrument that could permit me to mix my musical roots with the other words, musical words like the American blues, like the Brazilian, like the tango, Argentinian. And so I found this instrument that is not so easy because it's big. It was made for a big hand, you know, because. But I think is one instrument that permit me to found, enjoy, and share musical inputs from outside and to recreate for new project. So I play a last like tarantella, and we can try to play it together. It's very easy. I'm going to do something very easy.
Thank you.